In this training module, you'll be learning how to perform a hill start and practice the switch from throttle to braking as you crest a gradient and go from ascending to descending. For this introduction, you'll be driving the LMS Stania Class 8F locomotive hauling a train of ICI hoppers. To begin, let's prepare the locomotive. First, ensure that the combination brake is applied. For this introduction, the combination brake has already been applied for you to prevent the train from moving. Next, you will need to set the reverser to the full forward position. This will ensure that the locomotive has the maximum amount of power available to it. The small ejector is currently closed and should be opened when the train is running. Sanding is important for maintaining grip on steep gradients or in bad weather. You can use the indicated lever to apply some sand to the track, either in front or behind the locomotive. You will need to apply some power to prevent the locomotive from rolling backwards once the brakes have been released. As you open the regulator, you'll begin to see steam coming out of the cylinder cocks. You will also notice the steam chest pressure going up on the lower gauge of the hub. Vary the regulator pressure to settle the steam chest at a level of pressure without causing wheel slip. This may take practice. The large ejector needs to be fully opened to ensure that the brakes have been fully released across the entire train. As the locomotive is now ready to go, the combination brake can now be released. As the brakes are now released on both the locomotive and wagons, you should now be moving. If not, carefully increase power using the regulator. If you apply power too quickly, the wheels will slip. If this happens, reduce the amount of power to regain control and gently reapply. Now that the Yeah. Congratulations, you've reached the summit. Watch the locomotive speed as it crests the top of the gradient. You'll go from needing power to maintaining speed to finding that power is starting to increase acceleration. When you see that, start to close the regulator and aim to keep your speed in control. As you start your descent, begin to control your speed using the combination brake. come to a stop up ahead at the indicated location. Good work. That concludes this training module. It's highly recommended that you practice both hill starting and the change from ascent to descent until you're comfortable with them. They are one of the more challenging aspects of operating heavy freight, and you'll really feel like you're in more control of this train as you get the hang of this task. In this training module, you'll learn how to read and react to semaphore signalling that you will see on this line. The signal you see in front of you is called a semaphore signal. These indicate the current signal aspect based on their position and colour. When a red signal arm is horizontal, referred to as being on, it is showing a restrictive aspect and you should stop. Once stopped, you can contact the signaller to request permission to proceed. When a red signal arm is at a 45 degree angle, either up or down, it is referred to as being off and may be passed. A yellow signal arm is a distant signal. These give you an advanced warning about upcoming signals. When you see a horizontal or on distant signal, you should slow down as one or more upcoming signals will be displaying a restrictive aspect and you should prepare to stop. It may not be the next signal showing a restrictive aspect, so proceed carefully. When a yellow or distant signal is at an angle, either up or down, it is also referred to as being off and indicates signals up ahead are also showing clear to proceed. Remember, you can always just look at the heads-up display if you are unsure what the next signal is. The signal in front of you is showing a restricted aspect. Wait for it to clear before proceeding. The signal in front of you is now off, which means you can safely pass. Drive to the next station and remain vigilant of signals that you see on the way. Thank you. prospect, stop in front of it and wait for permission to pass. If you pass a red signal when it is on, the session will end. This is called signal past a danger, or SPAD, and in reality could end the driver's career.
Thank you.
That concludes this training module.